Okay guys, here we go. It's just one after another, and I hope that this proves and shows to you guys that you are not alone. And I just got into Socrates, New York. I was posting on my story, you know, that I was just passing through. I'm getting to my next location, but God always tells me when to stop. I got out and I see all these butterflies, and I was just telling you guys I felt like there was a reason for me being here. And I'm walking and I pass this beautiful man. He asked me if I wanted to sit down and if I wanted to talk. I asked him what his name was, okay? And get this, I tell you guys all the time that Jason guides me. He's my biggest guide on the other side, and he tells me that his name is Jay. So please listen up. This is my beautiful new friend, Jay. Hi, Jay.
Hey, how's it going out there?
So what brought you out here? What's a little bit of your story, just to give them a background?
Yeah, well, so I was on the road full-time for like 5 years or so. Just like couch surfing, pretty much, you know, moving every like 3 to 5 nights. And then COVID hit, and I was able to find a really nice situation. One of the places I had stayed occasionally, I was able to stay for a long time. So I had kind of committed myself to trying to do this like mobile thing to counteract the 7 years I had spent with one person, married, trying to like settle down, really trying to like have a certain thing in my head happen, and then realizing that it wasn't gonna happen and that I needed to stop trying to like know anything really and just like expand outwards, connect with people, you know, be really open. And so the last year and a half has been a really beautiful like recalibration for me, actually being intentional.
I think that is a big thing.
Yeah.
So the only way that we can be intentional is if we are in the now, right?
Right.
So that's the only place to move. And I personally believe, and maybe you agree with me, is that COVID pushed us very deeply into this place of being intentional, having to be in the now, having to be with our feelings, having to be with everything.
I mean, I count myself among the lucky ones. And so now here we are, and like I've got, you know, 6 years deep into this commitment I've made to myself, and I was sort of trying to jump ahead to the next thing, like apply to all these jobs, like waking up at 6 a.m. and like writing job applications and like apartment applications and like really trying to like go back into the normal world. And it was just like, it became very clear that it was not gonna happen. You know, it was too obvious to the normal world that I had been outside of it for too long, and so it was pushing me back. And realistically, at this point, I'm like glad that it did. Like, I had a big turning point a couple days ago where I was like, oh, I have to just actually keep doing what I've been doing. Like, I have to see this 7-year mission through. I can't just give up because I've been burned again and 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 again. I have to actually keep going.
I want to focus on what you just said, because that is super important that I want anybody that's watching to understand, because you guys know my journey. And I just went to New York, I followed God, he told me what to do, I applied for all of these apartments, and something just was telling me this is not right, this is not right. The more people I talk to, the more people that I connect with, the more I hear these stories of things are just not going the way that we in our, that go back to the norm, to the 3D matrix, to the way the things that used to be, that we used to play this game. Things are rapidly changing right now, and it's not allowing the people that are here to do certain work to go back into that field. We're all being pushed to do something different, and if you think about it deeper, there's a reason for it, because there is a new world birthing, there is a new age coming, and we need these people. So if you are feeling that, if you're feeling that like being called to be awake and to be in a different place than you've ever been, I encourage you to go for it. This is just another mirror of going into the unknown, but you even said that when you felt grateful that it rerouted you.
Oh my goodness, yeah, it was such a breakthrough, honestly. Because it was this super tragic and hard thing for me. Like, I've been trying to work towards like establishing myself in an alternative way for 6 years, and like, I mean, I really love to adapt. Like, it can be really good for me to be adaptable. And I'm always sort of willing to throw everything away, like if that's what needs to be done. And I'm glad I went through that process of like really trying to like be normal again.
Yeah.
It was like really liberating in a way, like just to realize that I could do that. Like, I could try. Now I'm like, oh no. Like, this is the final level of this section, And I need to incorporate everything I learned in the last year and a half with the 5.5 or 4.5 years before that and actually do the thing I've been trying to do well.
Yeah.
Like, just to do it well. It's not about abandoning it or like pushing. It's like settling into it and being gentle and intentional and really doing it well. Yeah, so here I am in Socrates. And honestly, like, this has been like such a stretch for me to actually keep movement happening in my life and not just make the most of what I already have.
Is there anything that you can think of that you can tell somebody watching that they're not alone in?
Oh, sure. I mean, the main thing that just pops in my brain is like mental health struggles. Like, I've been diagnosed with bipolar 2, and it's like, I mean, the manic thing's not as bad for me. Like, it's really more like very intense depression. And it's usually more like once a month for a couple days, but the last, honestly for me, it's been way harder transitioning out of COVID. COVID was like, oh yeah, I can just be home. Like, that for me was like beautiful and I was lucky in that. But trying to transition back into like normal life has been incredibly difficult. And for me, a lot of times it's irregardless of circumstance. Like, it's so easy for me to be like, well, I'm so lucky, I'm so privileged, I shouldn't feel how I feel. But I think that's the main thing that I've really realized for myself, is it's not actually about my circumstances. Like, my moods just swing. I am going to go through depressive periods regardless of how good my life is. And it doesn't help for me to beat myself up about it. Like, I really have to be okay with that. And as long as I'm okay with it, like, it cycles. Everything is cycles. Like, that's another fundamental thing for me. Is everything is cycles. And so when I can actually just like settle into that and be okay with it, it's not as big a deal. Like, I can go through periods of depression and if I'm gentle with myself through that, it's not that big a deal, and it comes and goes. But it has been extra hard recently, and I think that's probably true for a lot of people. But you just stay with it. You just keep putting your feet in front of you and drink water.
Yeah. I think that's really important to digest, is that there's cycles, you guys. There's cycles with everything. And there's ebbs and flows with life. And please take this, you know, from a brother of mine that is just meeting heart to heart, that, you know, you're not alone in the ups and downs. You're not alone in it. And to be gentle. That was beautiful, to be gentle with yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a tough one. I mean, I feel like I have a long way to go still. Like, I can be very gentle, and I can also not be very gentle, especially with myself.
Thank you.
That's it.
I appreciate you very much.
Thank you guys.
Yeah, thank you guys. And, you know, please take that and just know that you are not alone. This is a moment of love, a moment of reflection. Whatever you're going through, you're going to get through. Take it from people that know. We love you. Madge, signing out.